In CSS, you first write what's called a selector, and this defines what elements of the page a particular style will apply to. You can select an HTML tag, and that rule will apply to all tags on the page. And if, for example, you want to apply style to all paragraphs on a page, you can do so by writing the following. Another way to do so is to select elements by class. And this is what we did in our previous example. So if we want to write a style that applies to the class description, we do so by typing .description. And inside the brackets, you write the style in the form attribute colon value. So for example, we can say attribute color is value red. You can also combine selectors. So for example, you can select all links that are inside an element with the class article. There are links to the instructor notes for more information on this. Now, earlier we said that red wasn't really the best color, but what if we wanted to learn more about colors and how to define them? Logically, we could say instead of typing red, I might want to type blue or black or any other color. But what if I want to get more specific? There's got to be a way to do that, right? Of course there is. I mean, CSS has a lot of functionality, and it's impossible and unnecessary to go into every detail right now and memorize all possible attributes and values. I mean, you'd probably fall asleep at your computer right now, and none of us want that. Instead, you should get comfortable referencing the CSS documentation. We've included a link in the instructor notes. In exploring the page, you'll see that there are a lot of attributes that you can use. For example, going back to our color reference, we can search for color. Scrolling through the documentation, you'll find examples of different ways you can define colors. You can find the color red we used before. You could also call RGB colors. Here you'll find the color red example we used earlier. You could also call hexadecimal colors or even RGB. Going back to the documentation, let's do a small exploration into font properties. Search on the page for the font style attribute. Then answer the following question. Which of the following are possible values for the font style property? Is italic a possible value? What about bold? Or normal? Is that a possible value? What about standard? Also, which property would you use to make the text look bold?